The Baltimore City unemployment rate is averaging 10.3% so far this year, and that's above the state and national figures.
And, of course, tonight, City Council President Jack Young is pushing a proposal requiring contractors to hire local residents first. I-Team reporter David Collins is live in City Hall with details on that. David?
Well, Marianne, we talked with one out-of-state contractor about it, and he likes the concept. But we did some checking and found it may not work as well as it sounds.
This $40.5 million construction project upgrading a segment of the city's aging sewage system is run by Carp Seca of New York. It's not uncommon to see out-of-state license plates at the site. Since it is a Baltimore City project, some wonder why more locals aren't hired.
Look at the number of young men and women that are looking for employment right here in the city of Baltimore. They should be benefiting from their tax dollars of these contracts that's going out to all these companies, some who don't even have a base in the state of Maryland.
City Council President Jack Young, through a resolution, is calling on the City Mayor's Office of Employment Development and other city agencies to investigate the benefits and risks associated with creating a local hiring preference program. The construction supervisor of the Stony Run project believes it's a good idea.
If it's city money and it's city taxpayer money, why not allow the citizens of the city to benefit?
But in cities where local hiring is already a preference, elected officials have run into legal problems and other unintended consequences. The City Council President's office listed three areas of the country where Baltimore City could use as examples. In Milwaukee, the city law gives locally based companies a 5% bidding cushion. But last month, the law was challenged. Complaints allege the preference is a disincentive for contracts and the practice will result in less competition. The city defended the practice, claiming there are no signs of lost interest. Portland, Oregon used federal stimulus dollars last year to partner with a private company called Clean Energy Works. The city agreement required new hires to live in Portland. Calls to Portland City Hall to determine if the pilot worked were not returned. Sacramento County, California discovered the law can backfire. It cites a case back in 2004 in which the Federal Highway Administration withheld $700,000 from a road project in Cleveland on the grounds Ohio's local hiring law was illegal. Building contractors in California call the proposal the opposite of free trade.
And how would this work legally?
Well, we're looking at how we can do this. You know, I've been meeting for the last, I could say, last 8 or 9 years. This has been my big push to try to get city residents hired on some of these jobs. Oftentimes, these companies come in with their own workforce, and we're not saying don't come in with your own workforce. We're saying we want you to hire some of our folk as well.
A Baltimore City executive order on the books since 2007 encourages hiring locally. We asked the Mayor's Office of Employment Development whether it's working. We didn't get a direct answer. They emailed us saying, in part, the office will continue to explore ways that increase the number of employment opportunities for Baltimore City residents. Reporting live from City Hall, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.